Hi there. Today, let's learn how to create drag-and-drop questions. A drag-and-drop question includes multiple drag sources and drop targets that require learners to match correctly. To insert a drag-and-drop question, open the Interactions tab and click drag-and-drop. A new question slide will appear on the canvas like this. It has the question title, drag sources and drop targets, feedback messages, and a button. Each drag source and drop target is a shape with a clickable image button inside. Use this button to add images. Or, click the default text to add your text. An object as a drag source has a light green marker. Meanwhile, an object as a drop target has an orange marker. There are orange drag-drop connectors which connect drag sources with drop targets. They denote that dropping the drag source to the drop target is a correct action. They appear by default, but you can hide them by clicking drag and drop in the View tab. A drop target can accept one or multiple drag sources. But each drop target should accept only one drag source as a correct answer. If there are more than one accepted drag sources, when learners drop them into a drop target, they overlap each other. Now, let's get to know how to customize this question. To add drag sources and drop targets, select the question and click this green button. After that, a new drag source and drop target pair is added towards the bottom. It's good to rename drag sources and drop targets. This will help you identify them easily in many places. To change the drag source and drop target positions, click and drag the drag sources or drop targets to the desired position. However, before doing that, make sure the None mode is selected. Otherwise, you can't change their position. For more information on this, you can refer to the video group Layout of Questions. There are some ways to edit drag sources and drop targets. That is, you can add text, insert images, or change the formatting like you do with a normal shape. To set correct answers of questions, click the drag source to show the marker, and drag it into the drop area. Then, the drag-drop connector appears. Alternatively, you can select the drop target, go to the drag-and-drop section of the Properties pane, and define the accept list. On the other hand, to remove a drag source as the correct answer, click the drag-drop connector, and press the Delete key. In the Score and Reporting section of the Properties pane, you can define question properties such as the number of points for each correct answer, max attempts, and the total amount of time users can interact with the question before it's disabled. As other types of question in ActivePresenter 7, a drag-and-drop comes with events and actions that are ready to use. However, you can change them the way you like from the Events, Actions section. For example, I add the Go to Slide action to the incorrect event to make the presentation go to a specific slide. Now, take a look at the feedback messages and the button here. They are inserted by default, you have to access the Slide Master view to edit them. In the View tab, click Slide Master. Then, change them the way you like. After that, in the Slide Master tab, click Close Master View. You can refer to the video Working with Slide Masters for more information. Now, let's see the result. That's all you need to know about drag and drop question. Thank you for watching.